Hey, what's going on, guys, and welcome back to Hearthstone. Now, last time I told you guys that I would be doing this arena run because
look, we have no quests. It's so sad. We have no quests,
but we do have enough gold to do an arena run. So that is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do another arena run with you guys. Saving up the gold for the other wings of Naxxramas would just take way too long. I mean, I did it once, yes, but I really don't feel like doing it again because it takes up so much of my time and resources that I could be getting packs for. The next Naxxramas wing will cost me... I'll show you guys, that way you know. It'll probably still cost me the same amount. 700 gold. That's the equivalent of $7, I guess. But 700 gold I need to do this. Or just to buy the full adventure, I could get $15. But yeah, that's what this is. Unfortunately, I don't think Blizzard has gift cards that you can get, so Grandma, if you're watching this, you can't really get me like a gift card for Blizzard or anything, I don't think, so I mean, I can't really do much except for arenas and stuff for you guys at the moment. Anyway, we will do an arena run. I will do an arena draft now for you guys. Purchase complete. Let's see what I get. Mage, Warlock, or Warrior. Last time I did Hunter, so we'll do Mage this time. Indeed I did. Is it just me or does she just look badass? Just the way she is. Okay, now we have the Light Warden, which is a shitty card altogether. If this was a Priest deck, I'd say it different, but it's not. Ancient Mage, 2/5 for 4 mana, give adjacent minion spell damage plus 1. Twilight Drake, gain 1 health for each card in your hand. These are all pretty bad cards at the beginning. To be honest, I'll have to pick the Ancient Mage. Okay, we have Ascension Shieldmaster, Bluegear Warrior, and Flamestrike. Flamestrike is a good card overall because it deals 4 damage to all enemy minions. And Ascension Shieldmaster is a decent card overall. 3/5 for 4 mana. It's a nice card. I mean, it's good and drafted. In Arena, less so, I guess, but a Flamestrike is going to be what I have to go for. Okay, so now we're getting into some early game here. Sorcerer's Apprentice, Frost Elemental, or Wolf Rider. Frost Elemental is pretty good. It's not as good as the Water Elemental, which freezes things every time it attacks. I kind of think that's weird, because I think the Water Elemental should have the freeze a character battle cry instead of the Frost Elemental. I think the Frost Elemental should freeze anything it attacks, but it is what it is. The Sorcerer's Apprentice, 3/2, it's a... What do I always say, people? It's a Bloodfin Raptor. Forget the fact of its spell cost reducing. I mean, yeah, we got Flamestrike, but again, forget the fact that its effect. It's a 3/2 for 2. Can't beat that. Okay, Epics, Spellbender. Whenever an enemy casts a spell, someone a 1/3 as a new target. Blood Knight. All minions lose Divine Shield and gain 3/3 for each shield lost. That would be perfect in drafted. Here, not so much unless you have a lot of Divine Shield. We don't. Pyroblast. It's just a decent mage card overall. Deal 10 damage for 10 mana. It is so worth it. Just to see the look on your opponent's face in arena when you suddenly throw a Pyroblast to end the confrontation. But Spellbender is a pretty good one too, but I mean, could you imagine the look on your opponent's face? I'm going to use Pyroblast! Spellbender. Suddenly, he's dealing 10 damage to a 1-3. That's the look on a mage's face when you deflect their own Pyroblast using a Spellbender. Priceless. Just epically priceless when you see that type of thing happen. But again, you can't really hope that your opponent has spells. Of course, I mean, they'll have some sort of spell, but you can't say anything about it actually being cast on a minion. Which again, the Pyroblast to your face won't be deflected because Spellbender is only for on a minion, not the hero, so Pyroblast is going to be my choice. Just because it's Pyroblast. More epics! Or no, these are rare, sorry. Kirin Tor Mage. The next secret you play this turn costs 0. We don't have any secrets at the moment. Crazed Alchemist, swap the attack and health of a minion. That would turn this into a 2-5, into a 5-2. This into a 2-3. Counterspell. Definitely. You want Counterspell. When your opponent casts a spell, counter it. Goes for Pyroblast too. Alani Berserker, Polymorph, and Direwolf Alpha. To me, there is no comparison. It's Polymorph. Frost Elemental, Torn Warrior, and Oasis Snapjaw. Now, we don't have much early game going for us at the moment, so I would pick the Oasis Snapjaw for... No, the Torn Warrior, sorry. I'd pick the Torn Warrior for the early game. Okay, Polymorph, Ice Bearer, or Priestess of Loom. We're getting to some better cards now. Commons and... As this goes, Ice Barrier is a very good secret because it gives your hero 8 armor instantly. Priestess of Alun, we've already discussed this in the last arena. It's not a very good card. 6 mana, 5-4. Restore 4 health to your hero. I believe it's not worth the mana that it costs to do all this. I mean, well, okay, actually, it is worth it, but it restores 4 health to your hero. So yeah, I guess I'm just going to sit here and contradict myself. Priestess of Loon is a good card, especially in Arena, because you can't always count on other cards like the Darkscale Healer. Or, I don't know, like if you're a druid, you can't count on Healing Touch to always be there. But Ice Barrier I'm going to take for the early game. Mana Addict's a joke, Ancient Watcher's a joke, the only pick here is Stampeding Kodo. Young Priestess is a joke, Bloodsteel Corsair is a joke, Argent Commander is not a joke. It's a 4-2 for charge and Divine Shield and 6 mana. It's a joke for its attack, for its stats, but its abilities kind of make up for it. The simple fact that you could at least get one good attack in, even if it's to the opponent's face. You could possibly get in 2 attacks because of its Divine Shield. Mana Worm, Oasis Snapjaw, and Cult Master. Mana Worm, we have Ice Barrier, Counterspell, Polymorph, and Flame Strike, and Pyroblast. So that it would be worth it to take it, to be honest. Not Pyroblast so much, but it'd still be worth it to take the Mana Worm. I mean, we have stuff that would proc off of. It will even proc off the coin, which you're liable to get while you're in Arena. And we got Cult Master, Oasis Snapjaw, and Mana Worm. Cult Master is a pretty godly card because of its draw mechanic. It's a 4-2 for 4 draw card. To be honest, out of these two, I'd probably pick the Cult Master. But because I need the early game, I'll have to go to the Mana Worm. Okay, so we got the Abusive Sergeant, again, awesome card. Scarlet Crusader, another good card. It's got Divine Shield, so it's guaranteed to take something out with it, usually. Unless you're a mage and you pop the bubble. Raid Leader, it's a trap. It's a 2/2 for 3 with, and it gives other minions one attack. It's a trap. Now, the Abusive Sergeant isn't a trap because its low mana cost allows you to chain it with other creatures that, say, like my Argent Commander. Play turn 7, Argent Commander, Abusive Sergeant, or if you still have the coin by then, Argent Commander, Abusive Sergeant, suddenly you're doing 6 damage when he first comes out. That's decent for a 6 mana cost card. Especially one that has Divine Shield. Oh look, he's got a Lord of the Arena. You summon the Argent Commander, coin out the Abusive Sergeant. I mean, that's when the coin can be really handy in the late game. And suddenly you've taken out his Lord of the Arena, and you have a 4/2 minion with a charge on the field that just took it out because it was a 6/2 instead. And the Divine Shield protected it from the 6 damage that it would have been dealt to. You just took out a 6 mana cost creature with another 6 mana cost creature that survived. That is awesome. It is the best thing you could ever hope to do. So I will take the Abusive Sergeant. Okay, Cone of Cold, Shield Bearer, joke-ass card right here. It's a 0/4 taunt for 1 mana. That is a trap. Just as much as the Goldshire Footman. If not more. Because it has 0 attack, so it's not dealing damage when it's being attacked. At least the Goldshire Footman deals damage when it's being attacked. Polymorph, decent spell. 4 mana, turn something into a sheep. Very decent. Cone of Cold, freeze a minion, and if the minion and the minions next to it deal 1 damage to all of them. So that's a very decent card too. I think I might take that because I haven't used Cone of Cold much. Wisp, joke card. War Golem, 7/7 for 7. That's very decent. I mean, you can't really expect much more than a 7/7 for 7 unless you're getting into like legendaries. Fen Creeper, 3/6 for 5 with taunt. It's got the keyword big going on for it. Anything that's 5 or above, I believe, you would include the hidden keyword big. Yeah, that's just how it goes. Like the War Golem here. He is big, not just for the sake of being big. He is big and can back it up with the 7 attack. If he had taunt, watch the fuck out. The War Golem will whoop your ass. Now, I've got some late game. I don't need this. But I need some more mid game, so I'm going to go Fen Creeper here. Frost Nova, freeze all enemy minions. Just freeze them where they fucking stand. That can help you out so much. Give you one turn to pull out that Pyroblast that you need to just obliterate them. And since we have Pyroblast, it really works well. Say your opponent has a Lord of the Arena, a War Golem, a God forbid Core Hound on the field. Any big cards like that, you Frost Nova, fuck their shit, they can't do anything. You throw out the Frost Nova or a Cone of Cold against 3 big creatures like I just described, they can't do anything. And then the next turn, oh look, I top decked Pyroblast. Boom, game over. By that time, you should have the guy down to 10 health at least, unless it's a priest. If it's a priest, you better hope to God he doesn't have a whole lot of healing cards. Of course, that's a priest anyway, they heal. That's their hero power. They heal things. But out of all these, I'd probably have to go. Oh, we got a mana worm. I mean, it doesn't hurt to have 2, but I mean, I'd go Frost Nova. Hey, look, there's the Mana Worm again. Flesh Eating Ghoul, that's a decent card, especially if you have cards like Mana Worm. These are all decent cards right here, by the way. Mana Worm, we've got enough spell synergy. Mad Bomber, it's a Bloodfin Raptor. A Mad Bomber is a Bloodfin Raptor. Now, there is an expansion coming out in December for Naxxramas. For Hearthstone, called Gnomes and Goblins. And there's a card in there called the Madder Bomber. It's, I think, a 5-cost 4/6 or something, I think. It's up there in stats, though. I mean, its stats more than make up for its high cost. And its battle cry is deal 6 damage across the board. Randomly across the board. So it deals 1/1/1/1/1/1/1, but that was probably 5. I'll just say another one just because of it. 1. Across the board. That can really come to bite you in the ass. I mean, I've seen Mad Bomber do horrible things to somebody with it. I mean, I've seen him hit your own hero for all 3 of that damage. I mean, imagine the Mad Herb Bomber doing shit like that. It'd be horribly bad luck for that to happen. But it could still happen. That's the problem. But the Mad Bomber is safe enough with just 3 damage split between all other characters. The Mad Bomber will still survive. It'll still be a Bloodfin Raptor, but there will be damage dealt across the board when you summon it. The Flesh-Eating Ghoul is I consider it a decent card overall because, yeah, it's a River Crocolisk for 1 more mana, but that 1 more mana also gives it the ability of whenever a minion dies, gain 1 attack. If you have a deck that has lots of minions, Flesh-Eating Ghoul rocks. I mean, he's awesome. Especially if you have things like mirror images that will die before they even get to the Flesh-Eating Ghoul. That beefs it up to a 4/3 right there. I don't have mirror images at the moment, but Flesh-Eating Ghoul is still a decent card just by its stats. It'll at least take out a 3/2 with it. But I always like going for 3/2s, so I will pick the Mad Bomber for not just the early game, but because it's a decent card all around. Stone Skin Gargoyle, decent card. You've seen what I can do with it. But that's in a priest deck. Booty Bay Bodyguard, 5/4/5 with taunt. It's decent. Celsi Deckhand is a joke. Booty Bay Bodyguard is the only pick out of all of these. Because you can't really buff the Stone Skin Gargoyle as a mage. At least that I'm aware of. Goldshire Footman, why are you showing up? Just to be tormented? Joke. Trap. Wolf Rider, decent. I mean, 3 mana, suddenly you've done 3 damage. It's pretty much like a spell. Just cast it, 3 damage immediately. You can take out something small. You can deal 3 damage directly. Polymorph, decent card. I'll probably go for Polymorph. Eero, Arcane Missiles, Leper Gnome, or Lord of the Arena. They're all decent cards, to be honest. I mean, Leper Gnome, even if you can't use it, it still deals 2 damage. Immediately. I mean, just Leper Gnome, summon it. Oh, look, so he used Arcane Missiles or something like that. Oh, look, it still does 2 damage to you. Sure, it didn't deal 2 damage and then 2 damage, but it still dealt 1 set of 2 damage to you. It's guaranteed damage unless it's silenced with, like, Earthshock. Arcane Missiles. Badass card. It's a Mad Bomber, except it's enemies instead of your own guys. It's just a awesome card all around. I will probably Now, the thing is here, yeah, Arcane Missiles is 3 damage split randomly among enemy characters. There's that word again that I don't like, randomly. Lepronome is 2 solid damage to the enemy hero. That's the thing. Lepronome deals it to the hero. You don't have to worry about Arcane Missiles just going across the board and hitting everything except the hero. Now, normally Arcane Missiles is used to get rid of things across the board, like the Lepronome, or a Abusive Sergeant, a Mad Bomber, possibly, maybe Sorcerer's Apprentices, Bloodfin Raptors, pretty much. But, or even the Tauren Warrior, if you're lucky. But Arcane Missiles is usually meant to take care of the little guys, if it can. If not, cool, you've done 3 damage to your opponent. Have you done it to the hero? If you've done it to the hero, more power to you. If you've just dealt 3 damage across the board to, like, 2 to a Lord of the Arena, or, I don't know, 2 to a Fen Creeper, that's less helpful. Unless you have something that can take out a 3 or a 2 or a 3 at the moment. Lepronome is just generally good, so I'll take it. Ethereal Arcanist. If you control a secret at the end of your turn, gain 2/2. Now, this is actually a pretty good card right now because we have the counterspell. And that's pretty much it. But the thing is with counterspell, you have to wait for your opponent to cast a spell. If you use Ethereal Arcanist and you have the counterspell out, they would want to actually trigger your secret to make sure that the Ethereal Arcanist didn't get boosted. Counterspell, decent all around. Wailing Soul, not so much. And Wailing Soul is good when you have like the Eternal Watcher or whatever it's called. Because then suddenly it's a 3/5 that can't attack, you know? It's decent. But otherwise, Wailing Soul's not a very good card unless you can find like a card that reverses spell effects. Like, oh, silence your other minions. Okay. Doesn't help me. Suddenly you have a card that reverses that. Silence your opponent's minions. Okay, there you go, you know? But I don't think they've come up with a card like that. So the pick here would probably be Ethereal Arcanist. River Crocolisk. I don't like it. Young Dragonhawk, I don't like it either. The clear pick here is Mirror Image. Mirror Entity, that's a good card. That's a good secret. Mana Worm, good card again. We've got one. We could use a second. But it'd be better if we had Mirror Entity because of the Ethereal Arcanist. If we have 2 secrets, I believe it doesn't stack. It doesn't gain like 4/4 instead of 2/2, but if they trigger Counterspell, we have Mirror Entity there as well. Of course, Mirror Entity is usually always procced, so we'll go for Mirror Entity just because it's a good card all around. Man, what is with these Mana Worms? I am not making an army of Mana Worms in this deck. Abusive Sergeant, that's what we want. Again, the Geomancer is a joke. Mad Bomber. Bloodfin Raptor. Potato Potato. Vaporize. That's what I want to see. Nightblade. Darkscale Healer. Gurbashi Berserker. The Gurbashi Berserker is a very decent card. It does not have an enrage ability. It's just gaining attack. If you can heal it with, say, the Darkscale Healer, or I don't know, just the Gurbashi Berserker, if you can, like in a priest deck, if you can beef up its attack, I mean, if you can beef up its health and then like inner fire it and then have it lose health, that's one hell of a win condition right there. I mean,
unless you're facing a priest, there's no really getting around that. Or a hunter with Hunter's Mark. That's another only way that you can actually get around that. Dark Scale Healer, it's a restores 2 health to all friendly characters. That's decent in and of itself. It's a Chill 1 Yeti for 1 more mana, and that 1 more mana gives it the ability to restore 2 health to all friendly characters. That's actually very good for us. I mean, like, healing... I don't know. Healing the Ethereal Arcanist, the Booty Bay Bodyguard, Fang Creeper, Stampeding Kodo. We've got cards that could use that. Then there's Nightblade, deal 3 damage to the enemy hero. I'm kind of wishing we had a Knife Juggler in here, because Knife Juggler, I did some bad things with Knife Juggler in my previous arena run. I only did it in one battle, but I still did nasty things with him. I think the thing is here is, do we want to deal damage, or do we want to restore health? You always want to deal damage, so Nightblade. Okay, so Abusive Sergeant, Ogre Magi, or Silverback Patriarch. And this I believe would be like, I believe you could call it a trap. It is a 1-4 for 3. The Ogre Magi is a 4-4 for 4 with 1 spell damage. Its stats are decent. Never mind the spell damage, its stats are rather decent. Abusive Sergeant is not really a one turn drop. It's just something that you combo with, like, say, like on turn 2 with the Mana Worm, just in case. But I'm going to have to say Ogre Magi. Joke card, what are you doing here? Youthful Brewmaster. That would be useful for, say, the Abusive Sergeant. The Abusive Sergeants, I should say. What other battle cries do we have? The Nightblade, of course. Ancient Mage, kinda. Youthful Brewmaster is just decent overall because you can also heal something with it. Pretty much, you return it to your hand and, well, suddenly that Fang Creeper that was at 1 health is back at 6 and you can summon it again, so I'm going to have to say the Youthful Brewmaster here. Fireball, Lord of the Arena and Dalaran Mage. We should probably get some sort of taunt in here, so I'm going to have to say Lord of the Arena. Okay, another rare, Big Game Hunter, very decent card. You normally won't get the battle cry off, but it's a 4-2 for 3. Shadow Naxxramas is a very decent card, 2-2 for 3, it'll always guaranteed be a 3-3 for 3. Unless you're facing an opponent that can get rid of stealth like the Hunter. Spellbender, another good card for, like, if you're someone using a fireball on, say your or the arena, suddenly it's going to a 1-3. Plus, this deck seems to be aiming towards secrets at the moment, so I'd probably have to say the Shade of Naxxramas just because it's a decent card overall. And that is our deck for this arena bout. Thank you for joining me. Like, comment, and subscribe if you think that I made some decent decisions or if you think I made some horrible decisions. Please let me know in the comments. Like, comment, and subscribe if you think that I'm doing Hearthstone too much. I did say before that I am doing a run-through of Five Nights at Freddy's for you guys. I hope you enjoy me screaming my ass off and getting the shit scared out of me by my roommates. Anyway, I will see you in the next Hearthstone video. Goodbye, everybody!